Hi, my name is Estelle Met, and I am the organizer of African Cultural and Health.
Hi, my name is Julian Hall. I am the author of the best-selling book Entrepreneur to Ultrapreneur, 100 Ways to Up Your Game. And the idea around entrepreneurship is to help inspire and motivate entrepreneurs to become more successful. Entrepreneurship is it's a key area which has been focused on by governments all the way down to the man in the ground as a solution to today's problems. Enterprise presents the opportunity for people not just to change their own lives and to create their own employment, but to change the lives of the friends and families and their immediate environment, and sometimes even their own cities and countries. But what makes a successful entrepreneur or a successful ultrapreneur? And in my journey as an entrepreneur, what I found is that the really successful entrepreneurs are ones who take a far more holistic approach. Yes, they drive for the contracts, yes, they drive for the money, yes, they drive for the success, but they've realized that taking account of all of the other areas in their life actually makes them a better entrepreneur. So what am I talking about? I'm talking about their mindset, their general health and well-being, the relationships they have with their friends and their family, and the support system that they have around them. I draw a similitude to a game of football, a game of soccer. The striker who scores the goal, he gets the credit, but all of the other players in the team created an enabling environment for that striker to score the goal. Without them, he couldn't do it. In entrepreneurship, that goal is the money in the bank, is the contract, is the new opportunity. But all of the assisting players is the support network, is your mindset and your well-being and your health and all of these things I've noticed. Once those are in place, you can become a far more successful entrepreneur because you have the necessary foundation. You have the base that you can build on. You can't build a house on sand. And if you're starting out as an entrepreneur, do not just chase the money, because the money won't be enough. You can create a very, very successful business using a very simple business model. You don't have to come up with the next Facebook. You can just go on eBay and sell stuff. You can write books. You can have a media production company. Or you might want to create the new Facebook. You might want to change the world. But if you don't have a really strong foundation behind you, you don't have a really good support network, you don't have people who can support you and be positive about all of the things that you're doing, then you'll run into problems. Things will move too slowly for you. And sometimes people can't recover from those types of failures. But two key things that you need to be very much aware of when you're on the road to entrepreneurship. Yes, they talk about passion. Yes, you do have to have a passion for what you're doing, but you've also got to be really good at it. No, scratch that. You've got to be excellent at that thing, because there is so much competition today in the world. There are so many people who want to become entrepreneurs, who want to become a success. And it's very important that you are highly, highly skilled. It's very important that you hone your craft and that you become the best at what it is you're doing. That will be driven by your passion. That will be driven by the reason why you want to do something, not just the pursuit of money, because that is not a big enough motivator. Look at what change you want to make and create a business out of that. And that could just be changing your immediate environment, the opportunities that you have. Create opportunities for other people, reciprocate, because all of those things go into what I call the ecosystem of entrepreneurship, the ecosystem of ultrapreneurship, which will, once put into a cocktail, will deliver a drink that will sustain you as a business person, sustain you as an entrepreneur, and see you very firmly on the road to success.
Hello, my name is Stephen Sally from the Marion Dina Research Foundation, a foundation that was set up by Professor Charles Sally, focusing on wellness and well-being. Professor Sally was a researcher in both Western and traditional medicine. He produced a range of food supplements called Marion Dina. Marion Dina helps to boost the body's immune system, give you energy, and repair body cells and tissues. It has over 99 different antioxidants, trace minerals, herbs and vitamins to help the body to heal and repair and regenerate itself. Today, the world is focusing on healing the body through good nutrition. What Professor Sally has discovered here is Marion Dina A, which boosts the body's immune system, gives you energy, repairs body cells and tissues, and also helps to actually repair the blood as well, and also helps to awaken your natural healing capacity. We also have Merindina J, which is great for detox. If you want to detox your body, this is the product for you. What this does, it helps to draw out toxins from the cells. It also helps to cleanse the body by improving liver function and kidney function. It also helps to actually stop the spread of cancer because it's got anti-cancer nutrients in there that help to actually do that. You've also got a process where this also helps you to actually improve the body's ability to heal by actually helping what we call the process by which the body cleanses itself. So you have a cleansing system. At the same time, you also have an energizer. Within Merindina, we also have what we call Merindina B. This is a range basically of over 28 different nutrients. This mainly is focusing on one thing, energizing the body, improving endocrine function. At the same time, you can actually begin the process of also energizing the way your system works. Because one of the things that we're looking at within this product is that your body is producing heat energy all the time. This enhances that process, as well as also improves your brain function, improves your heart function, also improves your sexual organ function as well. So this also helps to actually improve libido as well, but also is very good for energizing the body and keeping you strong. We've also got a cream. Merindina cream is very good for handling any form of skin disorders, urticaria, ringworm, acne, itchy scalp, insect bites. It's made of neem oil, arnica, calendula, zinc, and vitamin E. Aloe vera as well. All these nutrients actually help the body to heal because nature is provided with a healing solution to help the body to heal. Today, what we have is a healing system within Merindina that is unparalleled because it handles all kinds of conditions, all based on one principle. If the immune system can be raised to actually function at optimum level, the body's ability to heal itself is amazing. And what we have here is a product that just does exactly that. And today, Merindina is taking the world by storm because of one thing. The product actually works. It's very simple to use. It's natural, and it also works in harmony with the system in that your body is actually built on the basis of nutrients. Once you can empower the entire system to work efficiently, the entire system will actually move to a new level of performance. And this is what Merindina offers you.
And what we're going to talk about today is entrepreneurship. You know, it's an often used term, but exactly what is it? What makes a successful entrepreneur? What are the characteristics of a successful entrepreneur? What are the characteristics of an unsuccessful entrepreneur, which is as important to find out? Julian, I think what would be great if you could just sort of share with us your sort of general thoughts on the whole issue of enterprise entrepreneurship. Certainly talk about your book and books, best-selling, and then we can probably take the discussion from there. We've got a couple of questions which people imparted to me previously, which I'll put to you as well. And obviously, if anybody's got any questions later, I'll be happy to facilitate that. But at this stage, Julian, enterprise, small business, entrepreneurship, what's it all about to you?
Thank you, Jeffrey. Hello, everybody. How are we doing this evening? That's a very warm welcome. Thank you very much. Just staying in the moment. For me, entrepreneurship has always been about opportunity and grabbing that opportunity. So we had a gentleman, I'm not sure if he's still in the room, Mikhail Amin. Did we enjoy Mikhail Amin's performance earlier on? Yes. Yeah. And what he did was quite entrepreneurial in a sense, because in a very impromptu fashion, he took an opportunity that was presented to him. Yeah, do we all recognize that?
Yes.
Yeah. It wasn't something that was staged. He didn't know he was going to do it. But an opportunity came up for him to showcase his talent, and he took that opportunity, and he did very well, right? He did very well. And who knows, that video could go out on YouTube, it could be picked up by a record label somewhere, it could potentially change his life, all because he took an opportunity. And one of the speakers up here earlier on mentioned this thing about fear. And a very, very successful black businesswoman in the UK, when I first heard her speak, she said something that she learned from Puff Daddy, and that was, you have to feel the fear and do it anyway. Whenever I get up and speak, whenever I start a new business, whenever I am about to sign a contract, I'm always nervous. There's always an element of fear. But over time, I've created a habit that allows me to do it anyway, do it regardless, do it because it's right, not do it because I feel good about it necessarily, right? And I think that there are so many opportunities that exist for us in 2013. There were so many opportunities. It is often about us taking control of those opportunities and owning them and making them our own. And I think that is one of the key elements that makes entrepreneurs successful. I started out in business with friends and colleagues of mine, and we weren't the best at what we did. You know, we set up in digital media, we weren't the best. You know, I've never been the best speaker, workshop facilitator, never been the best entrepreneur. But what I've always done is I've always taken opportunity. And successful business people around me, I've noticed that they have a habit of taking opportunity, right? And opportunities around us every day. And I think one of the things that, Mikhail demonstrated, and it's one of the sayings in my book, that if you stay ready, you don't have to get ready. And what do I mean by that? Mikhail didn't have to consider what he was going to rap about. He didn't have to consider whether or not his voice was well trained enough. He didn't have to consider whether or not he's wearing the right clothes. It's almost as if he was ready for that opportunity, yeah? And that is a key element of success with entrepreneurs. Don't wait until the window of opportunity presents itself. By that time, it's too late because you'll fumble, you'll fall, somebody else will take it and execute it way better than you. Make sure that you are preparing now. Whatever it is you want to do, spend your time, if you're working 9 to 5, spend your evenings and your weekends preparing diligently for when that opportunity, that window of opportunity does present itself. You know, there's that old adage, you get 15 minutes of fame, right? It's probably a lot less than that now because there's so much noise, there's so much going on, there's so much competition. There's so many other people who want to shine. The people who end up shining are the people who are ready before that window of opportunity presents itself. Are we all feeling what I'm saying? Okay, now let's be honest. Who has had a window of opportunity that they've missed? Put up your hand. Right, that's the majority of us. Who has taken advantage of a window of opportunity that's presented itself to them? Right? Now the question for you is, what was the difference? That's what you've got to think about. Think about what happened when you took that window of opportunity and why you were able to do it at that time. And then think about what prevented you from taking the window of opportunity that did present itself that you missed out on. And I think understanding that, not just taking on board general business principles that you'll hear people spew out on a day-to-day basis, but understanding what it means to you, understanding what makes you tick, what makes you go over the tipping point of success. And I think that is another key success factor, understanding your own ability to turn what you have into progress, into success.